is led by Fidel Castro, his brother Raul, and Che Guevara, stormed the Cuban capital, Havana.
The United States established a quota, an amount of sugar that they would buy from Cuba.
Cuba es la gran productora mundial de azúcar, o una de las grandes productoras mundiales de azúcar para ese instante, y esos intereses económicos deben ser cuidados.
Beyond providing the Cuban government with a rationale for restrictions on its people.
Became an independent country in 1902 and immediately fell under the influence of the United States. The two countries are just 90 miles apart. Cuba's main export, sugar, headed for the United States. In exchange, U.S. companies improved the island's infrastructure and controlled the island's economy.
No Cuban politicians dared to brink with the U.S. until Fidel Castro.
They didn't promise anything. They promised a revolution. They need a revolution.
El problema del embargo es muy lógico. Si tú intervienes a un país, todas sus empresas, como hizo Fidel con las empresas americanas, que yo no sé cuántos miles de millones son, pues claro que tienen que reaccionar, por supuesto.
Following these events, Kennedy did everything in his power to overthrow Fidel Castro. In addition to covert military operations and secret attempts at Castro's life, Kennedy would also apply economic pressures. President Kennedy would further strengthen the embargo set on Cuba by the previous administration. The embargo would not only restrict weapon sales, but it would restrict all commercial enterprise.
He told Khrushchev, you should unleash the entire Soviet nuclear arsenals. Apocalypse.
This country will do whatever must be done to protect its own security.
Kennedy's assassin had been in contact with the Cuban embassy in Mexico.
He basically told the embassy personnel, who were really Cuban intelligence, that he'd kill Kennedy for the revolution, because he knew Kennedy was coming to Texas. And he said, his exact words were, I'll kill that bastard Kennedy.
whatever chances existed of easing tensions between Castro and Kennedy quickly dissolved with Kennedy's successor, Johnson.
What are conditions like in Cuba today?
Very
bad. Every day gets worse.
Fidel Castro is coming to New York to address the United Nations. His trip will be a serious problem for America's security people, since there will be many anti-Castro demonstrations.
What do you think the reactions will be to your speech?
A ver, yo pienso que mi discurso es un discurso constructivo, un discurso de paz, que llama a la colaboración entre los países.
Why do you want to leave Cuba?
For the system?
You don't like the system?
No, 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 no.
What do you think about this?
Well, I mustn't tell you here, okay?
Just leave me here.
Well, I applied to leave Cuba to, you know, my father, my brothers, and my sister are near in Florida. I'm waiting. You know, my father sent a boat to Mario already.
Why do you want to go? ¿Por qué quieres salir?
Yo, porque quiero la libertad.
No, there's no liberty here. You want to go to a country where there's some freedom?
Uh-huh.
Where were you before?
I was in.
You were in jail?
Yeah, before.
Him too?
Me.
And him too?
Yes.
What type of people went up with?
Crazy people, we got prisoners, they say political prisoners, we got some criminals. Who knows what kind of people we got here?
Un duro periodo especial.
Y ahora este país se le pide una misión extraordinaria: salvar la revolución en Cuba, salvar el socialismo en Cuba.
This far, I mean, you've got basically the frame built.
A couple of years. 2 años vamos a tener trabajo aquí.
Dos años. Not so fast.
Tenemos azúcar 4 libras.
One person gets one bag a month.
Aquí tenemos arroz 5 libras.
One bag per person per month. That's it. That's the ration.
Es
todo.
Sí.
El problema fundamental nuestro no son los problemas de Europa, ni los problemas de la economía norteamericana, el problema fundamental es nuestro bloqueo.
It's bad for Cuban people, for gasoline.
Yeah, maybe you might have some problems getting gasoline now because of all the troubles with the Soviet Union. What are you going to do if you can't get gas in your car?
Normal es transporte colectivo, la guagua.
Bus. £1 for person.
£1 for person? Yeah. For how long?
For 1 week.
That's it?
Nosotros no queremos mucho, nosotros queremos el suficiente nada más para vivir.
That's all. No more.
So,
this is what the kids have to eat in the school.
Yes.
You have potatoes.
Potatoes.
And let's see, over here. Eggs. You have eggs. ¿Qué tipo de carne?
No, carne no tenemos.
You don't have eggs.
Hoy por la noche no hay carne.
No.
No, not today. Not today night.
So if you want to get meat, where do you get meat from?
It's not easy enough.
Shut the door. It's okay, aquí.
Okay? Para que no se lo lleve.
So that nobody will come and kill him?
Sí, sí. Y si no se lo come.
Doctor, how old are these syringes? That thing looks like it's from the last century. Do you have sufficient facilities to sterilize all these old syringes?
No.
¿Cuántos meses usted está hablando?
A un mismo guante, bueno, eso depende de la dependencia que se rompa. Depende del uso que se le dé al guante.
What I can I do, my dear friend? What can I do?
You get really frustrated?
More or less.
Yeah. 1992, Cuba democracy has restricted the flow of medical goods into Cuba from the United States. This resulted in a precipitous decline in access to medical supplies inside Cuba. According to a 2010 review by two Stanford researchers, they believe that the lack of access to this medicine is responsible for several disease outbreaks in the country, including an increase in tuberculosis fatalities.
What happened to your animals?
Se lo comieron.
They ate them all?
Todo. Todo, todo. No me quedaron ninguno.
Hasta el caballo.
The mere 90 miles may not seem like much, but no ferries or boats are available to the Cuban people.
What do you want the people in the United States to know?
Estamos en el año 1995.
This is 1995?
Sí.
Uh-huh.
Yo tengo que cargar agua. Tengo que traerla desde más de 100 metros.
You have to walk 100 meters to get water.
Subir por la escalera.
Climb the stairs.
Sí, subir por la escalera. Entonces tengo mi madre enferma. No hay medicina. Todo el mundo se quiere ir.
You?
Claro.
¿Usted también?
Ah.
Everybody. Everybody.
Where? ¿A dónde?
United States.
Turismo es hoy necesidad imprescindible de nuestra economía.
What was your job? ¿Su trabajo antes?
Químico industrial.
You were a chemical engineer. What was your job before?
Mecánica, ingeniera mecánica.
You were a mechanical engineer and now you're here selling plates in the market.
economic sanctions rarely work. Trade and investment sanctions against Iran, North Korea, and Cuba failed to change the behavior of any of these repressive regimes. The sanctions imposed in reality only worked to deepen the repression and deprivation of the individuals in these countries we claim to be trying to help.